Well, welcome, dear students. As we are supposed to begin when MA Final 8A paper, a new poet, Thongun. I just today would like to give you an introduction about the poet, and then we will continue with the prescribed poems in your course. Now, we should and we must have a little bit background about an idea about the poet before we actually start with the text, so that it is very easy for and comfortable for us to understand the works of any particular writer or a poet. Now, Thongun, as I think won't be difficult for us to understand, he was an English poet, and he was praised for his early verses in England, where he was associated with the movement, and his later poetry in America. Even after being moving towards a looser, free verse style, that is what Thongun is famous for. Now, what exactly we need to know a bit about Thongun is that we're not concerned much about his birth and the other things that's important. For more than 40 years, this award-winning poet, he was concentrating on traditional form and in contrast to modern themes. Like, he has spoken of panhandlers, he's talked about homosexuality and many, many latest modern themes. He had spent most of his life in America writing in traditional verse about American issues and subjects that he had done. Now, no matter if he was born in England, he was a child of a divorced parents. Then he traveled with his father a lot and he moved from town to town. He served in the British Army for 2 years. And after serving in the army, he started living in Paris and began to write there. And then he moved to Trinity College, Cambridge, where he focused seriously on writing poetry. Now, Thongun also became an essential part of his work, the discipline and structure that characterizes early work, and combined with the Californian with its subject matter. So Gunn said that coming to America changed everything for him. He began reading free verse, and he was much influenced by the works of Wallace Stevens and William Carlos Williams, and embraced American culture. He used to say that there were other things that he could do. That he started out with a heroic stuff full of Shakespearean like heroes. Gradually, by the time he was living in San Francisco, he could write a poem on an old man sitting in a doorway. But the form remained, whether describing the countryside, native island, California. He adopted a singular purity of measure and tone, and this was something which keeps a unique place of Thongun in the British poetry. So we'll explore more about the poet with reference to the poems, and we'll start with a beautiful poem, On the Move, by Thongun, in the next class, in the next lecture. Thank you so much.